Hey guys, good morning and welcome to the Kids on the Hill service. I'm Pastor Jeff Coleman.
And I am Carmen DeLella, and it's great to be here this morning. Now, Pastor Jeff, I have a game that I would like to play with you. It's a trivia game.
Yes.
Are you ready?
I love trivia, yes.
Okay, here comes question number one.
Okay.
Listen, where in the Bible would you be able to find some? A, in the New Testament, or B, in the Old Testament?
Ooh. That's a great question. I'm going to go with B in the Old Testament.
Perfect. Wonderful. That's one.
All right.
Okay, now, are you ready for number two?
Yep. Love
okay.
it.
Okay, question number two. What is a psalm? A song or poem written to express emotion to God, or B, a cartoon in the Disney Channel?
I would like to say B, but I'm going to go with A.
Yes, good choice.
Okay.
Perfect.
Good,
okay,
good.
That's wonderful.
Hey, friends, you know, I've heard that you and the entire church have been memorizing Psalm 23, which is awesome. Let's do this. Let's check out this really cool video and say Psalm 23 together.
Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Wow, you guys did a great job with Psalm 23. Here's what I need you to do. Sometime in the next week, would you say Psalm 23 to maybe your friends or mom or dad, maybe your grandparents? Maybe even God. God would be cool. So, yeah, that'd be great.
Okay, Pastor Jeff, we're yes. still not done with our trivia questions.
Oh, yes.
I got now question number three for you. Are you ready for this
yep.
one?
Let's do it.
Okay. It says, who did David say was his shepherd in the Bible?
Oh.
A German shepherd.
Okay.
Or B, God.
B.
Perfect. Great job. Friends, as we conclude Psalm 23, let us not forget how God is our shepherd, and he's always guiding us.
God is our shepherd, and he is always guiding us. He's always leading us to do the right thing, leading us in the right path. In fact, God in the Bible is described as the good shepherd. So let's do this. Let's watch this video from John chapter 10 about God being the good shepherd.
The Good Shepherd and His Sheep, from John chapter 10. Very truly, I tell you, Pharisees, anyone who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way, is a thief and a robber. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him because they do not recognize a stranger's voice. Jesus used this figure of speech, but the Pharisees did not understand what he was telling them. Therefore, Jesus again said, "Very truly, I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who have come before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep have not listened to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that are not of this sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd. The reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life, only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. This command I received from my Father. The Jews who were there gathered around him, saying, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, tell us plainly." Jesus answered, "I did tell you, but you did not believe. The works I do in my Father's name testify about me, but you do not believe, because you are not my sheep. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hand. I and the Father are one."
Wow, friends, that was a great parable that Jesus told. Now let's make sure that this week we read John chapter 10 with your family, and let's go ahead and worship the Lord together now.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. And I will fear no troubles, but until that day comes, we'll live to know you here on the earth. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear?
Wow, that, Miss Carmen, was an amazing worship video. Kids on the Hill, just remember, no matter what you go through, God is always going to be with you. God will never, ever leave you. So let's do this. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you so much that you are the Good Shepherd, that you lead us, that you guide us, that you take care of us, and that no matter whatever we go through, you're always going to be with us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Wow, Pastor Jeff, I had such a great time today.
Oh, yeah.
Playing our trivia game, learning about God's Word, and worshiping together. That was amazing. I hope to see you all next week, yeah. And have a wonderful weekend.
Hey guys, don't forget, get mom and dad, grandparents, anybody else, your friends, join us 10 o'clock for Church on the Hill. We'll see you soon. Thanks for tuning in. Bye, friends.